God, I have an announcement to make. Remember when I told you that we are going to pull off the most amazing heist of all time by stealing the moon?
Yeah!
Right!
And that all I had to do was get a bank loan to build a rocket and we were all set?
Go!
Yeah, well, that didn't work out so good.
Yeah!
Mr. Perkins at the Bank of Evil says we have to start paying instead of borrowing, or else he will do unpleasant things to me.
Perkins.
I heard that, Tim. Anyway, I have decided that none of that matters. Out there in the world are plenty of rocket parts. All we have to do is find them and take them for ourselves.
Right!
Before Vector can build his rocket and get there first. Yes, unfortunately, a new villain, Vector. He also, it seems, wants the moon. So, we're kind of in a race to get there, all right? Don't worry. We are much, much smarter than Vector. Trust me. Really? Dr. Nefario has assured me that he can, if we get all the parts, build the rocket. After that, the moon belongs to the number one master villain in the world and his awesome team of minions! That's us. Okay, let's all get ready, everybody. We have some training to do before our first heist.
Before you go running off, let's take a look at how weapons and minions work. First, there's the air gun. It could...
Wait. Why is it that you have given me an air gun?
Hold up. You told me to build a weapon that could blow away anything.
If you... Never mind. What were you saying?
Yes. Well, the air gun doubles your jump height. Just jump a second time while in the air to activate it. Give it a go. The air gun can indeed blow away some enemies. Why not try it out on this fella? Enemies that run away can't hurt you. And attacking things that can't hurt you is, well, despicable. Doing things like that increases your level of despicableness. Your despicable rating, if you will. We'll talk more about that later. Your trusty freeze ray can do lots of cool stuff. For instance, you can blast these hot platform thingies and make them safe to jump on. If the ice starts melting, you can refreeze the platform, but you have to be quick. Moving platform doohickey thingamajigs also freeze. They stay still when you shoot them.
Thank you.
Although you're very springy, you'll probably want to avoid being crashed. You can freeze pistons to make a safe path. Some of your enemies too. Try blasting these laser turrets and see what happens. Now, every enemy can be defeated by at least one of your weapons. Oh, I always forget which is which. You'll just have to experiment. But experimenting is fun. As I said before, there are plenty of ways to be despicable. Whenever you come across objects like these, you can do marvelously nasty things to them. Go on, try it!
Much better. Lovely.
You can also be despicable to your minions. They might complain, but they'll always come back for more. Go on, give it a go. When running and jumping won't get you through a situation, it's time to send in the minions. They can help you with puzzles. They're very useful in that way. Now, you can command the minions to stand in formations, each of which is affected by your weapons. Now, minions must be in formation before your weapons affect them. Create a single minion formation and then blast it with your freeze ray. That was fun, but it can be useful too. Now, some buttons, like that yellow one, stay down when pressed. Go ahead, step on it. Now, others, like that red one, only stay down if there's something holding them down. Order a minion onto the button and make an ice block, like you did before. Good! Now, you should be able to use ice block minions to weigh down just about anything, and to act as floating platforms in water. Not that I've tried that, of course. Your air gun should also affect the minions, I think. Order a single minion to stand directly below the button on the ceiling, and then hit him with the air gun! Oh, he's got a bit of an inflated opinion of himself, hasn't he? Well, at least he's good at pressing overhead buttons and lifting things, I suppose. You can also make minion towers. Now place a tower formation on your side of that gap in the floor and blast it with your air gun. You can use a minion bridge to cross gaps to support other formations and to catch falling objects. Now, Let's try the circle formation. Set up a circle formation and then hit it with the air gun. You have a minion fan club! See how it moves the floating minion so it can get to the overhead button. You can get rid of a formation when you don't need it anymore. Use the controls to cycle through your formations and disband the fan. Good! When you don't have enough minions to make new formations, you can just get rid of formations you don't need anymore to free some up. Well, don't just stand there. Get going! I wonder what would happen if you used the freeze ray and the air gun together. Shouldn't be too dangerous. Let's give it a go. Let's see. Why not try operating that button there using ice and wind? So make an ice block and then blast it with the air gun. Whoops. I wondered where I put that thing. Well, no matter. Let's see if we can get it out of your way. Make a circle formation and freeze it with the freeze ray. Then blast the ice ball with the air gun to roll it into the statue. You can also make an ice tower, which blocks openings and stops wind from fangs and stuff like that. Go ahead and make one. Now, let's see what the air gun does to it. Well, that wasn't very useful, was it? Ahead of you is a puzzle map pickup. Each one provides details on how to complete one puzzle of your choice. To use a puzzle pickup when you're in a puzzle room, go to the puzzle room zoom mode and activate the puzzle map. And scroll through the steps. Pick it up and try it.
Yoink, mine.
That was a freebie. When you're out in the real world, you'll need to conserve puzzle maps. You don't have enough for all of the puzzles. Let's move along. Good news, Gru! I've located an engine for the rocket. In the 60s, there was this fellow called Cam Shaft that became famous for stealing engines of all sorts. He was an awesome mechanic, and his greatest creation was a cluster of rocket engines that he sort of patched together from old missiles. It should work beautifully for our purposes. Now, I'm more of an idea guy than a planner, so Dave here will explain the rest. Sounds easy enough. Good luck, crew.
suffer for this? All that effort for this. You have an original groove. That is beautiful. Supposed to get past this. Thank you. Bye, guys. Kids, don't try this at home. Michelangelo, I am not. Thank you. Why does this keep happening?
Tonight's top story. A daring break-in at a local building today has authorities baffled. A businessman who works in the building, one Mr. Perkins, says the robbery occurred at around noon. He had no further details on the incident other than to say that the building was, quote, not, repeat, not a bank. Who said anything about a bank? An object, which appeared to be a rocket engine of some sort, was seen being carried through downtown streets by what witnesses describe as a group of very short plumbers in overalls. More details as they become available.
Crew, we need hull plating for the rocket that can take a lot of pressure. And I know just where to get it. Vector's lair. And Tim here will fill you in on the details.
You make it to the Vector's house. And it's underground lab. Make it to the submarine. There, hull plating has a toy that delicious. Make it to the Matatatalas and a peep of cake.
Cake?
Cake! No cake.
Quite so. Questions? No? Off you go, then!
Go home while you can, Groo!
Uh-huh.
plumber guy gets coins, I get this.
To country now, you old has-been. The coolest trap.
Oh yeah!
all mine! Take it away!
That is beautiful. Much better.
You think you can get away with stealing my stuff?
All that effort for this? Tutorial for you who can't fight yet.
You think you're so good. Well, you are. Good at being bad at being good.
Gru, I'm afraid my plan for an electrical power source for the rocket came up a bit short.
Papa, Nakalo, sang a stupid plan.
No, it was a lovely plan. It's not my fault you couldn't manage to find me enough extension cords to stretch 250,000 miles! So, anyway, backup plan. There was a villain called Nick Eon, who used to be really into neon signs. He stripped Vegas clean back in 82. He installed a small nuclear reactor in his bank vault to power his collection. It should be perfect for our purposes.
Makatotaro and Nick Eon.
Oh, he's not around anymore. Radiation poisoning.
Yikes!
At any rate, the reactor is waiting for us in the Bank of Evil. Get in there and bring it back.
Yeah.
Now. Good. minions to the group lane!
I don't want to be a backseat pilot, but I have some tips for you. The minion ship ahead of you is for transporting the item you steal. It's fully shielded, so you can just sit back and... Oh, wait. You forgot to install the shields. So I suppose it's up to you to keep them safe. The minion ship won't make it if you don't stick with them. Oh, and make sure you don't get destroyed either. That would be rather unfortunate. I've scattered some goodies along your course that should help you with any enemies you encounter. Survive!
Precision flying, baby!
Heists or hoaxes? Reports have come in from all over the viewing area of the theft of what appeared to be a nuclear reactor and of a daring air battle in the skies above our town. The first word of this amazing story came from the vicinity of this office building, where reported robbery of a facility that was not a bank took place not long ago. Are pollutants in the water supply just making the population crazy? Again? Or is our fair city under siege by a despicable master villain bent on destroying us all? Stay tuned for more information as this horrifying story continues to unfold. Now we go live to our own happy homemaker, Betsy Callahan, who has some yummy recipes that won't break your bank. Betsy?
We need a radar tracking system for the rocket, and Dave has managed to locate one.
Powerful radar, secure facility as an problem. Vector.
Yes, you will have to go and get the item from Vector's lair. But the good news is that this facility is so heavily defended, they'll never expect you to try and break into it.
This is the good news?
Oh, I'm sure you'll have no problem. You're a little scrapper. Have a nice trip.
Bye-bye.
Fight!
art critic, but I know what I like.
Oh, like you could do better.
Thank you.
Vector, won't mind us borrowing this? Gru, what's here? That is beautiful.
Well, well, look who's back for more.
I got past my defenses last time.
But this time, oh, I've got more surprises up my sleeve.
Up another excellent weapon for your arsenal, Gru. Come down to the training level and I'll see if I can remember what it does. Rocket is coming along even better than I'd hoped. We actually have the next parts I need. Those stabilizer fins the minions picked up at Mormart. So, Gru, you can just relax for the moment because...
Hello, Gru.
Vector!
Yes, the little yellow thing is right. It's me, Vector.
If you think I'm going to let you get away with this moon heist thing, you are as pathetic as your lab's defensive systems. That's right. I broke in. No problem. Easy peasy. Figured I'd just grab those stabilizer fins and use them for my own moon rocket. That's right. I'm going to steal the moon before you do. Unpredictable!
Hey! Ma, motherfucker, fins.
Well, no. I didn't get the fins. But I did manage to turn all of your tricks and traps against you, so good luck getting those fins, crew.
By the time you finish fiddling around, I'll already have a miniature moon to add to my collection. Oh, yeah!
You can do better. Uh-oh.
painful. Now. Something that was a lot to go through for something I already own. Ta-da! Kids, don't try this at home. You're controlling me?
Bad news, Gru. The good news is that I've found a fully operational command module for the rocket. My brother, Reprehensio, built one for the rocket that his former boss, Drew, was going to use to steal Mars a while back. That's turned out badly, so he doesn't need it anymore. The bad news is that, unlike myself, Reprehensio can be a bit, shall we say, absent-minded?
Oh, do tell.
Yeah. Difficult to believe, I know. Anyway, instead of shipping it to you, Gru, he sort of shipped it to Drew.
Ah, well,
Ooh.
Drew's vault at the Bank of Evil, to be precise. Drew isn't with us anymore.
What happened to him?
Defective command module.
That's encouraging.
Yes, but Reprehensio says the problem has been corrected. Not to worry. It's sitting in his vault at the Bank of Evil. Oh, and Reprehensio accidentally called the bank when he meant to call me. So they sort of know you're coming. You'd better approach by air. Good luck, crew!
Michelangelo, I'm not. Whatever happened to keys and locks? Myself. the overcomplication. Suppose there's another way around. Not going anywhere.
Downtown area is buzzing as yet another daring robbery is pulled off in broad daylight. The third such crime in as many days. This is the first one that has been positively confirmed by eyewitness accounts. One witness of the event described the heist as totally cool, Mon, and said that someone who could pull off such a despicable act must be one of the greatest criminal minds of all time. When asked whether he thought that the man behind the heist might be the up-and-coming supervillain Vector, the witness turned surly and stormed off. Authorities are baffled, and it seems clear that we're in for at least 4 to 5 more daring heists before it's game over for the mastermind of this crime spree.
You're here! Good! As you know, we need a high-pressure tank to hold the rocket's fuel. I've found one that will do nicely. Unfortunately, it belongs to Vector. And of course there are probably insanely complex traps that will make it very hard to get to. Oh, and at this point in the game, I'm pretty sure he knows you're coming. So, good luck with that. Now, Tim and Dave have a map and some of their little minion babblings to share.
Super dangerous. Nikki took them all. Ah, so ridiculously hazardous for Zappa.
No, I'm sure Gru is perfectly fine with the plane. Off you go, Gru. You go and get the whatchamacallit and bring it back. And then I'll do whatever it is that I do.
Alright, my persistent friend, I'm ready for you this time!
I like stuff. Freeze ray!
What? You got past that?
What a lovely bonus! I am no art critic, but I know what I like. Oh, there's much. Here we go. More danger. Can it never be just walking through the door? Enough is enough already!
Oh!
This is very challenging. I don't like this.
That is beautiful. Ta-da!
My fortress of Vectitude is unbreachable! Stop breaching it!
Is it working? Are you feeling secure yet?
that plumber guy gets coins, I get this.
Forgot about gas!
Oh, is that what it is I am smelling?
No, that was Dave. But that's not what I mean. We need fuel for the rocket. And, as the game design would have it, I know where you can find some. The highest security vault in the Bank of Evil is owned by a Mr. Hugh Morgood. Now, he has this obsession with ice cream and has commissioned dozens of works of art on the theme. He also has one of the biggest private ice cream sellers of all time. Explain to Gru why this is important, Dave.
Banana split! Banana!
Oh, why it's important to the mission, Dave.
Liquid nitrogen!
That's right. The best rocket fuel there is. Morgood uses it to keep his ice cream frozen. And there's a fresh canister stored in the vault. Go get it, Gru. The moon is so close now, I can smell it. Or I could, if smells traveled through space. And if the moon were actually physically closer. Oh, anyway, good luck. And bring back some Tutti Frutti. That stuff's yummy.
Pick up items. I'm so despicable, I can't stand it. Gru was here. Don't you think? grab something else then.
Come on!
Thank you.
it? Liquid nitrogen? Cool. Ah, just go. Oh, that's much better. Yes, that's more like it. For this?
Rocket engine, a portable nuclear reactor, a spacecraft command module, and now, a canister of liquid nitrogen. This is the shopping list of the mysterious thief, who's been repeatedly plundering the downtown area for the past 8 levels, days, or so. A team of crime scene investigators has been working around the clock to solve this baffling case. Although their conclusions are far from final, they have determined what the villain is most likely constructing. A nuclear-powered, rocket-propelled freezer with a seat. The uses to which a clever villain could put such a diabolical device are endless. Stay tuned as further developments unfold.
As you know, there's one more piece of hardware we need. A shrink ray. Now, we had one, of course, but as you may recall, Vector was able to... how to put this delicately? Steal it right out from under your nose? So, now, your only choice is to break into his lab, find the shrink ray,
and... Hold on, just 1 minute there, Gramps. Do you think I'm going to let Gru and those little yellow things of his just waltz into the fortress of Vectitude and steal my shrink ray?
Well, that would be nice, yes.
Well, forget it. My defensive systems are running at full vectitudinal capacity, which, in case you don't know, is pretty darn good. So if Gru comes snooping around here again, he better watch his step.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah. Oh, no.
You heard him, Gru. This is probably the toughest job yet.
Never get to it. It's too well hidden. Too well hidden. It's totally in a different direction than where you're going.
Oh!
That is beautiful. Much better. Game designers, always with the traps and the puzzles. Webgun! All over again, right?
Bring it, bring it, bring it, bring it, bring it. design such a thing.
This is just crazy!
Help! Help!
is it. Last piece of the puzzle. One more level and the moon is mine.
Come on.
Help!
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 Glue! The rocket is completed and the shrink ray is charged and ready to go! Yes! But the only problem is that I've discovered that Vector has his rocket ready as well.
Ah!
But you could still make it to the moon first, if you hurry.
Yay!
Of course, that may be difficult because the lab defenses have been activated. Again.
Ah!
You see, the inverse calibration on the main stage flux chillers backfired when the system was purged, causing a massive feedback loop in the compensator.
Yeah!
Huh? What? Oh. Ah! It means the game designers always make the last level the hardest! Just go and get to the rocket before Vector does!
Yay!
Yay! Yay!
Thank you.
Ta-da!
Gru was here. This is dangerous. I need a better agent. Oh, this looks tricky. Grew. I am no art critic, but I know what I like. Watch it! Thank you. that effort for this? This is it! Next stop! The moon! Oh, Dave, how many times have I told you to take care of that before the level starts? No, no! Not now! You will have to wait until we get there!
Victor is ahead of you, Gru. You must stay with him, or all is lost!
It's just a dick. It's just Factor, the moon is mine!
Who's the sucker now, Groot?
And who's not the sucker? Me!
Oh yeah! Ah!
This is not good! Control! This is Groot! Mayday, I need help, now!
Oh no!
Ah, hello, back in the lab! When someone gets in moment, could I have a little help here, please?
Sorry about that, crew. A minor distraction. Your course should be corrected now.
Yes, but... No, it can't be.
Oh, yeah. Who's got the moon now? Me! Vector, that's who! Best villain ever! Oh, yeah!
No, no! Vector is taking the moon. I worked so hard, played so many levels. I can't let him have it!
Groo! You can still stop him! I've sent a signal to reverse your shrink ray! If you get there quickly...
I am on it!
Come to Vector, you beautiful little moon. Did not see that coming.
Oh, yeah!
Sweet.
Who just orchestrated the first Grunar eclipse, huh? This guy! That's who! Gonna be famous!
13th man on the moon!
Ow!
Yeah.
Ta-da!